our Scottish programme with Rachel Hay. Today is partly cloudy, a maximum of 18. It's 14.7 in Byron Place. Sun protection is recommended until 20 past 4. The UV index predicted to reach 7, which is high. Wednesday, showers developing, 9 and 16. Thursday, a shower or two, 9 and 17. And Friday, mostly sunny, a minimum of 9 and a maximum of 21 degrees. Time now, 12:30.
Eskema agus falcha ganu Rèidio Albannach Astràilia-a-Deas ec coig EBI yn 93.1 FM. Digitach EBI World News Rue ger yn lainia. As mis ar yn eich nich gari. Good afternoon and welcome to Scottish Radio Hour here at 5 EBI 103.1 FM or Digital EBI World. My name is Rachel Hay and a special welcome to anyone listening from further afield with our streaming service at www.5ebi.com.au or now available on catch-up for 8 weeks at the same address. How are you today? As always, I'm going to start with This Week in Animal News. Agus hasornan is good an an orban an shachgansha. Vai a cwyd an an ysgedan fat blina gul agus haiolach yn ymbiach nach dŵr sôn yn arach yn yn ysgydyn gwn fach y rhif ro sio. An egg from a critically endangered flapper skate has hatched in an aquarium in Oban after being artificially incubated, which scientists think is a world first. It took 18 months for the egg to hatch, and the skate hatched folded up and was released into the sea at the Sound of Jura Marine Protected Area in Loch Sinasht. Hanig and Sornan, a machas and a filcher, I guess higher and could, muscule on and lar glacier fasca jura, nor about a troy a leat. A stock can be a da meta gale and leat, I guess a marsing fat lechy at blina. The skate was released when it was 27 centimetres wide, but adult female flapper skate can grow up to 2.5 metres long and live for 50 years. Researchers say they now have a better understanding of skate gestation, which will help protect them in the future. Halach rannsach I agraag a fel iol os nes iar ac yn eis i'r gwr sornan, agus gwn thwr sy'n cwdiach agor am sornan y ienig sy'n awmri chach. Jane Dodd, the Marine Operations Officer, said, "We still know very little about the lives of flapper skate. For example, how often they breed and where and when they lay eggs. The total gestation of this egg was 535 days, so it is similar to that of orca and sperm whales. Knowing the length of time eggs take to hatch is a really useful piece of information for understanding the life history of a flapper skate, which in turn will improve how we are able to protect them. Hurst Sheena Dodd, Chanyel Fisaking, Jacho Trech Savias, Sorn and Aginchen, Agus Kach, Agus Kunya Viaset the Bre Uyen, Agus Kudjak, Hurst Stefan Benjamins, As an Ushkid and Anan Open, Hashiner Jalvan a Hawkel Gach Shaking, Gus Fasforach and Sorn and a Scrudig. A hiln curra meeson, hoshikit triclaric, lesh a camera, fat na hunya, agus marshin, urit video, yen surgeon in a chin a machas anu. Stephen Benjamins from the aquarium in Oban said, "We have been photographing the egg every week on a light box to observe the development of the embryo. A few months ago, they also set up a video camera recording around the clock and were able to record the moment the skate hatched. Flapper skates were put on the critically endangered list in 2006 due to overfishing, and in 2009 it became illegal for fishermen to catch them, and if they do, they have to be released unharmed. Chai sornen and cwr er yn lista gyrich gydol a bi, an yn da fila sa sia, agos tri blian as jay shen, noch bachig am bre. Han skira fashg eir djura, na skira gienas namara, agos bi sornen ag ein shen an shet. The Sound of Jura Marine Protection Area is a breeding area and fishing is restricted so that the skates can't be accidentally disturbed, although anglers can still catch and tag them, which is how the egg was collected. Flapper skate are considered extinct in most of their traditional range, and the west coast of Scotland is one of the last remaining places to find them. Ha sornen dol a bi, aon an imagach a fan roed vachionata, ach turv an aloping, turv ir an aloping. Ach an talov, ha fisrach a gwr ni siach yn bygin na fys ylar a vare a gichia, aon sa niad achica. Shema grota yebu aon a niad ylar a vare, hai colach. Nai canyanich, och gishan an canyanich, coig yow vore, da lach riavach, Fulamer, Pahach, Kjarkruich, Meskachig, Gio and Ella, Kretavik, Nora Ella, Agus Uan. Back on land, workers at the Royal Society for the Protection of Birds have searched an eagle's nest in Uist after the eagle and its chick left this summer. They found many things: 17 rabbits, 5 geese, 2 wild ducks, a fulmer, a puffin, a moorhen, a mixture of other birds and small animals, and a lamb. But I vore reckon RSPB, alma via feiching, na rach na hilarin, agus an tishan achka erinead, as jay achal as taurig, or sho chofata an ear sa ha hilarin ir needachig huik a sho. Saune elan an rana an an yuisht, a ha an ead. Ha, the RSPB was very interested to see what the eagles had left behind, as this is the first time eagles have nested so far west. "We have a number of eagles nesting on the east coast of Uist, and they largely live on seabirds," said Robin Reed, who searched the nest. "Sea eagles sometimes go up to 20 kilometres to get food, but this pair were going west to the Mache and feeding on rabbits and geese there. Ha grun yllerin aging neadachig coast a shed, Uist, agus ha eatsan ge irivor tiin bio yoin vare. Bi yllerin mare urenan adol suas ri fichet kilometr son biagain, ach yn car eich efa sio, fai at y dol chwyr yn i'r cwnnafach yr ys biachag yr cynion eich agos ioi yn sin. Ysdoch yn achro yn RSPB chotol eich ti ywain y lor ag ys yn ned, ys tŵa hyn eich agos croch yr yn ffad ymig blian a yrfi a gyaran gyfel ylwyr yn a ffal of lebeich yn. A chai colach gyda nach dy chwyr eich drach rof o'r e robyn. The RSPB wasn't particularly happy to find a lamb in the nest, because farmers and crofters have been complaining for years that eagles are stealing their livestock. But nevertheless, Robin isn't very worried. "It's clear they didn't survive on lambs at all," he said. "We don't know what happened to this lamb, but given the evidence we have here, it seems that lambs were a very small portion of what this pair ate. Hai folishach cudjach na chroet a tiin bio e uain ijit, a chanyal fisaking je hachar gan uain jo. Leis an ianis a hagging an seo, a colach gwna oain na'n cwyr yn gleifech gen na fan yn car seo a gichia. Gajeraf, ha biach gan yn yw eich gwmfyrdd yn y hil o'r un, a fi in the hiller in a via crotcher in a chudjachig. In fact, it seems that the eagles might actually help crofters. Chrissy Link from Ballagremastal said, with the figures we got and what they found of geese and rabbits, that they have helped a little here, because this year there was an abundance of rabbits on the machir. If they help in this way, we'll be happy enough to have them, as long as they don't do too much harm. Chanyomi bolachin jach ach gerchig and curry crotch and falch ora, horst Chrissy Link, aha na clark Ballagremastal. Lesh na figure na oa shin, as na hugget, as jay yoi, agus jay chanyonich, save an blianna va na chanyonich palch vachere. Hayat beck and fame again of an shin. Maniad fame san doi shin, ni shin tolic a glor yoer, a chofad snach beet the jane of tuyig, sechor jechron. And one final animal story before we go to our first tune, and I want to introduce you to Nala, the cat who has been accompanying Dean Nicholson around Europe on his bike. Dean, a welder from Dunbar, was sick of his 9-to-5 job last year and decided to get on his bike and see the world. Hanala na jo ha chanyl fi sa'ch ymdi sgrif mi eisio. Jo chat, her yr fi a dol ffieg yn tyl, col yr ijen a dwn bar agos yn baich gaeche. Sawn awn sa fosni a hachr yr ije, a dol sŵas eich noch fasge Montenegro. Rhe i as i ei, agos nŵr rhan ag iet yn athfala, noch ge nach ro manaf sgelab eich agus fa eisiau na chadol a rhywlein. He made it to Bosnia, when he met Nala on a hill near the Montenegrin border. She chased him up a hill and wouldn't leave, so he put her on the front of his bike to take her to the next town. There, he discovered that she wasn't microchipped, and by then she had fallen asleep on his shoulder and decided to come with him. So far, she's travelled 10,000 miles and has her own pet passport. They've become a social media sensation, and you can follow their adventures on Instagram at One Bike One World. Both of those ones are a numeral rather than a word. Chananalm Shaw ha nala jech mila mil chen a huel, agus ha ked huel ech gehen echke. Hayet nala agus dean, nun realten namayan an solshulta, agus seren rich in lenten Instagram. So, how about a tune about a cat? This is Flowers of the Forest with Suitors of Selkirk and the Dead Cat. I'm not saying Nala's dead, far from it. She's living her best life, but I couldn't find another tune with a cat in the title.
Suitors of Selkirk, and down with the Earl of Hume, and here is the other broad laddies that wear the singles of shoon.
It's up with the suitors of Selkirk, for they are be trusty and leal, and up with the lads of the forest, and down with the mercy to deal.
It's fire upon yellow and yellow, on yellow and green, but up with the true blue and scarlet, and down with the singles of shoon.
It's up with the suitors of Selkirk, for they are be trusty and leal, and up with the lads of the forest, and down with the mercy the deal.
Our mitres are made for noddles, but feet they are made for shoon. And fame as a sip to Selkirk has licked his treaty the moon.
It's up with the suitors of Selkirk, for they are we trusty and leal, and up with the lads of the forest.
suitor in Selkirk, what sings as he draws his thread? There's gallant suitors in Selkirk, as long as there's water between.
It's up with the suitors of Selkirk, for they are been trusty and leal. And up with the lads of the forest, and in with the mousy.
Shimmer, ring, shing, so the
Cathy Ann McPhee singing Heemian Gaelric, I See Winter, which obviously we don't hear, considering we had our first taste of summer over the weekend here in Adelaide. But the winter Christmas holidays are a concern for university students in Scotland who don't know if they'll be able to go home to their families. Chanel Fisek Olenich Gan Lalapa, and B. Kerdach Dolgachi Gan Lanoliga, and Shachkin Shaw, Noch Fashgir and Dan Afarst, Jehushan, Aviris Alman Alapa, Le Olenich, Kerden Rave. I guess a million rave a fincher about gowns natalachan, farnach hill room galore down, as to sorshulta, a hummel as a hela. This week, nearly half of all positive coronavirus cases in Scotland were among 17 to 19 year olds, that is, students in student housing, hundreds of them, with thousands forced to isolate in student halls where spaces are so small it's impossible to keep a social distance. They've finally been told that they are allowed to return home, though, after weeks of being told they wouldn't be because they've now formed new households. But they can't use public transport to do it, and everyone else in the household, their own family, the household they were going to, will have to quarantine for 14 days, which means it isn't possible for some of the families who are, you know, essential workers or someone. Ach, bicaid ach dalgachi mi erichol, chro fat shachganin, ach, Chaf I ced ac y coel phobl ac y clachgig, agos bu eich holon iach sy'n tiawl ac ac y rhyw ffein cherub ac y gen y ffad coel y jig. Ach, ha Richard Lochhead, Minister of Olam, am biach nach bi arf yn môr y gai fydol gachi ar sgas gyfelu der son y fi eich ganol hai. Despite all this, Education Minister Richard Lochhead says he doesn't expect huge numbers of students to move home because, according to him, although they are struggling, he knows they want to be at university. They're enjoying the opportunity of making new connections and of meeting their tutors, albeit a lot of their learning is online, he said. Sering do olonech a dolgachi gan chilig, ach ha eag eiri ora a vi a biachga cimer a vishin a bool ag eid an olomachga. Students are able to move home permanently, but those considering it have been asked to consider how this would affect their access to in-person learning and to discuss it with their university. The president of the National Union of Students in Scotland, Matt Crilly, said, "We welcome that students will be able to return home on a permanent basis. However, we're disappointed that the government continues to talk up in-person teaching, which may keep students on campus and increase risks unnecessarily." Esma gymbyring da olenich dolgachi gynchilig hwrst mat crili a chomyn nash yn da olenich iawn yn alwpa. Ach ha miol dŵl yrin gyfel yn rieltas ast amach ffôl ymawn yn person. A fiesa cwmwl dyn olenich eir y champas agos y miodachig mahronion. A has yn aast y giri eir rieltas na halapa a fien iarstachig stiwrig olam gys yn bieg ffoldam eir asta of unrowing. We continue to call on the Scottish Government to strengthen teaching guidance so remote learning is the default and a reality for as many students as possible. And Professor Jerry McCormick, the convener of University of Scotland, said, "Students need to choose what is right for their own physical and mental health. Ha ek olenich ri roi, je ha kiarch de son an kuch slaanche ag a sunt ach gehen. Gemi orstenach, han suichig a ha shawl ash a virus, a kielachig gavel na roinian shin kialta ri slaanche an duich a fad. Ha socha gejer a vail na via fudach ek an olhai, an semester sha, agus fallum ag a ser of a shenaying a sha." Unfortunately, the current situation with this pandemic means that these choices for the students' own physical and mental health do need to be balanced with the wider public health context. There is a real benefit, we believe, in staying at university this semester and benefiting from the blend of both digital and in-person learning and the wider range of services and support that is available. So, I often read out news stories on the radio that I can't really comment on because it's talking about sea eagles in Uist or something. But here I think I have a right to comment. So I'm going to tell any students who are wondering what to do, follow Rachi, go home. Ha hola sheen erin etaline. Chanyel kedach at dolom achasante. Ha jo hjounts gum fayu of iris. Ha nadurna, koyetish screen a computer fatonwa. Ha at the gra. Gumbi o agian sych gan yn person, ec iawn siachgan, ec iawn mis, ach na bu a tors gred jes awn o sin. Biar i gwych a fi rachu, colwyr i stoch iawlwch, a coiat i'r sgrin a chympiwta yn siwt, fawr o fel dynia mwyn gwrst, ech a fel gra a gwrst. Everything is online these days. In student housing, you're not allowed to go outside. There's a good chance you'll catch the virus. You're alone, staring at a computer screen all day. They may keep telling you that you'll be able to learn in person next week, next month. But you can't trust that because things are always changing. You may just go back into another lockdown. It's better for you to go home, be with your family. You'll still be staring at the computer screen all day, but at least there are people around who care about you. Hanig mi hun rachu ag tosig a chyd semestr yn blin agos ha mi cho tankl gwn drain mi sin. Na bu a ffwrdych eich gynnol hei yn blin mae fi ys corym agod ag ôl rachu. I came home at the start of first semester this year and I wasn't sure at the time it was the right decision, but I'm so glad I did. Don't stay at university this year if you have a chance to come home. You're still learning on the computer either way. So Christmas. The Edinburgh Christmas festivals have been cancelled, as the City of Edinburgh Council has said that any event which could attract a gathering or a crowd will now not happen. Chafi feisn yn ôl y gawn yn dyneud yn y tachrysd yn blaen, ac ysgwrt chom yn y falle nach bu tachrysd yn dol, awn sy'n bu ag slwag. Fa sy'n gyma erson brosnach ag ys sol ys y torsd er dyneud yn y gawn yn ôl y gawn, ag ys tach y torsd er ciarst yr yn ynodol, hwrstiwr ych yn ieis. A chael slant a phob blac gyd fo cwdr ymach gain. We're very much wanted to bring some festive cheer and light to Edinburgh this Christmas and to support local makers and producers, said Charlie Wood, the festival director. But public health is our absolute number one priority. And closer to home, the Lobethal Lights have been cancelled this year, despite the relatively few restrictions we have here in South Australia. Chaweina Solishan an stra a voli an bliana get nach el moren an oren je bachgian. Charoch o gwnig sio ffyrsta hwrst niach lawrst y cholio. A hasyn erson yn coerys niach y cwmwl sael te, agos hasyn yn dochas gan ffeisyn se fwldo an aflian. The decision was not made lightly, a spokesperson for the committee said. But due to COVID-19 pandemic, our priority is keeping the community as safe as possible. We look forward, hopefully, seeing you all at the 2021 event. This is particularly bad news for Lobethal, which was forced to cancel last year's lights as well due to the Cuddly Creek bushfire. Hasho gomad dulach don corishniach an an stra na voli, a lesh gundur am falish gstach derenyesh an odi. Ach, jema yen stori aiach. Ha Lucy Main, she at reche blian at reish, a dunajan, litrach in a scriven gun shenavid. A half fudder fahter falov. I think we need a more cheerful story now. Lucy Main, a 26-year-old from Edinburgh, became her grandmother's pen pal when she started writing letters to her during the lockdown. Margaret is 86 and lives far away from Lucy and is deaf, so although the family tried to make Zoom calls, they frustrated Margaret because she couldn't hear them. Her maira cheer is kehir ichat, agus boa, agus get a geich and chelwch Zoom a clachig, chaburing do vairat and clinchin. Mae'r sy'n hosig Lucy rydw i'n gael yn y pen tyw gach siachgyn ac ysleidrych yn ysgrifig ac ysbeg maira tyw ysleidrych yn y chwyr yr eich hychgy. Lucy started painting her grandmother a picture every Sunday and writing up her weekly news. And Margaret would then send a letter back by the following Friday. I have loved getting those letters, Lucy said. I can't recommend doing this enough to people. So, while you think of someone to start sending letters to, it's probably time for our next song. And you may think that the Proclaimers only had two songs, but they actually sung a lot more than that. So here's one I hadn't heard before, Letter from America.
Track. Is brought to you by our sponsors, the Scottish Banner newspaper. The Scottish Banner is Australia's national Scottish newspaper, available each month with news from Scotland and the Australian Scottish community. Get your copy at newsagents or by subscribing at www.scottishbanner.com. For a good Scottish read, get the Banner.
Hello, Shivagay, Stuchri, Urejo, Albannach, Australia, Jessica, EBI, Ernani 3.9 FM, Digitach EBI World, News Through, Erin Lina. You're listening to Scottish Radio Hour on 5 EBI, 103.1 FM, Digital EBI World, or now streaming online. I'm programme Charles on Nayach for Alapa, Ayas von Pobble, Albannach, Ashaw, and in Australia, Jess, Agatha Hull of Doi. This programme is for those interested in all things relating to Scotland and the Scottish diaspora here in Australia. Nambeek Tolliv Balradio Avias, Chaneli Ach, Jech Dolliv Gachblina, Agus Viakshiv, Garkojach and Gajerov, Kurfon, Gumaira, Technoni Kehrin, Three Shach Dada, Koig Three Shach. If you'd like to help us stay on air, you can become a member for only $10 a year. To find out more or to get an application form, please ring Margot on 0413 722 537. I've not been sent any local notices for this week, but the online Royal National Mod is starting on Friday. Will run from the 9th until the 17th. A Mod National to Toshach Jehunia, agus be a marsing fat fashker call a jig. Via dull a vi alan in a niche, a high air closet ganetaline, agus hafis at Carson. It was going to take place in Inverness, but it was cancelled and moved online, and I don't have to tell you why. I was going to go over for it, actually, but moving online meant that I could send my entry in virtually. It also meant that rather than learning a set piece, I could choose my own piece from one of several categories. The usual event categories have changed, but there will still be a range of performances from children and adults, which will be showcased in a programme at the end of each day through the Comunn Gaelic's social media channels. Deputy First Minister said, "This has been a difficult year, and I welcome Comunn Rèidio's forward thinking in moving the Royal National Mod to a virtual platform this year. Hostiles free vinistia, ha a blena gredev erivi yawn, examitos falcha, er imust, a common lesh gundaglois et the vodreil, guola mas irach and blena." The Inverness Courier said that Comunn Rèidio announced the virtual mod this week, but the fact that it would be online, if not the actual dates, was made known back in April, and the deadline for submissions was actually nearly 2 months ago. Scríobh Cuireadh in níos gundanach go chumann an teachan seo go mbí a bhád deir in leine a chafís ar bhí ach gún ar sin bhí chéan mísan, agus bheith ach na hinsirtin a chuir isteach bhí chéan fásca dá bhís. Thúirt ceann ar sta chumann, Seamus Graham, ha sin éir le tolachta les a chuirt oirpa a rai na hulach o rointeach a gus videohan a chruich agus djéna da san a chuir isteach. Gan am seo, ha sin éir barach ga coig cead eintirtin aing agus méadach ag chóránteach etnáisinta ar a bhí ann, duine hóharis ar in America, Canada, Cymru agus Sassing. The Comunn Gaelic's chief executive, James Graham, said, "We've been blown away by the effort the participants have made in creating videos and submitting their performances. To date, we have received well over 500 entries, with a rise in international participants from as far afield as America, Canada, Wales and England." He didn't mention Australia, which is further away from Scotland than any of those places, and I know for a fact that at least one of us sent in entries. Hadurst and Counterst smitched me in Australia, ha na sacha of all up and a sassing your America. I guess a fees I can hang a keen chuck and the hood misha a hut the slower in just a stiach. Ach kayi, was do hen of odge could ye beast to hen of odge could ye get BBC Alpa, extradion and gale. I guess I mean dachas can the rindo, nyach na jeest, jenna look as jackshinaying. Be me hain a cumul solar na dulligan Facebook ek a chumun agus ek a vod in an ish hain. Aside from the social media programmes, more programming will also be on BBC Alapa and on Radio Nangale. And hopefully some of our listeners are actually able to watch that. I myself will be watching keenly on the Comunn Rèidio and Mod in a Niche 2020 Facebook pages to see how my own entries did. The other big Gaelic music news of the week is that a documentary about Pete and Diesel won an award at the National Film at the International Film Festival in New York. Rúnaigh program athraisteach mun Colin Elenach Pete as Diesel dúis ar feis etanáisinte ar an York nua. Sé Pete as Diesel, that's the way we do it, an tainm a bheir a program. Agus bhí a lentan na Balach a Lois, Callum Boydie McLodge in a Scott agus Ullam McLodge. The documentary Pete and Diesel, that's the way we do it, won the International Documentary Prize. For those of you who don't know who Pete and Diesel are, there are three guys from Lewis, Callum Boydie McLeod, Inna Scott and Ollie McLeod, and they rocketed up the charts last year, even presenting BBC Alapa's New Year's Eve programme last year. The documentary followed them as they worked on their second album and prepared for a concert in the famous Barrowlands Hall in Glasgow, which sold out almost instantly. Chéir an a chólan a séatadol vanyash gnyasht agus a chosnia clú leif hain a chosich eid a vi a clúd eid bach an dán a chlá agus a jesilachig ar son cyrm thón rich an an tala animal na Barrowlands an an glasachu. An program eil eis sôr a vich a laun an alapa nŵr a chai a chelting trás a giplin agus úr na harifan abuvoa jelwch gawr gach an channel an bliana. The documentary was a great success when it screened early in May on BBC Alpa, and it actually got the highest viewer numbers on the channel so far this year. Margaret Mary Murray, the head of Gaelic broadcasting at the BBC, said, "We're very happy that the talent of musicians and programme makers in the Western Isles is being recognised like this on an international stage. It's a testament to the widespread interest in local storytelling. Hashin eir out doi, gavel talent an luch gul, agus luch rúichig programan, sna helan an eir an achnachig, ma sio eir urla an eternasianta. Hurst Mairet Mari Farach, caunas creul a Gaelic a VBC. Fyr chestanas gavel oi arsing an an sgeelach gan inadol." So, how about a little bit of Pete and Diesel then? Here's That's the Way We Do It, performed live at the Barrowlands in Glasgow.
I'm nach Marche mi, strug nach Dolgurich mi, chida mechid, dim waren chachid, mishe yomag. Neide mich kvare, li galen se huan, ma vior ne rohe, ge ganyed hikoy, yar vin kashtu ere dachker er tmoy, na vichir egnen kraun am South Georgia. Stuag nach Dolgurich mi, chida mechid, Hacken nach Marie, Strug nach Dolgurich, mit China Mechir, dem waren Hachimische Jong. Chile bond nach Stukunaske, Gonuach, Tüten Kaskar, Kille, Fasmokar, Strug, Kregten Palches, Gentoya, Hurtwort, Jeschiloske, Taubau, Nadfort. Nach Dolgurich, mi chira mechir, nirinja hakem nach Marche mir. Zurück nach Dolgurich, mi chira mechir, dem waren Hachimische Jomag.
Arthur Cormack there singing Strug nach Dolgurich, mi chira mechir, it's a pity I didn't stay on dry land. And I'm running out of time to bring you all the sea-related stories of the week, but a bridge or tunnel between Scotland and Ireland is once again being considered as part of UK-wide review of public transport connections, or of transport connections, sorry. A dyna rhysd y biach gygig mi yn drach eich na tunnel eith yr alpyng ag ysering. Nach sy'n y rhysd mae'r pars gen asgrwydig a harialtas yn rhywch gen eich ien of eich anglwch yn cogl. Ach, chenial mi yn dŵl rhywf, can be that a cheering us and us crudder. I expect the idea will go nowhere, as it always has, especially as Scotland's Transport Secretary Michael Matheson raised concerns that the way the study was conducted undermined devolution, since it had been organised with virtually no consultation with the Scotland Government despite transport being a devolved matter. Cudjach, noch draugel le vichel mach vahen rúnir a chógal alpa a hurst gandra an asgrúdag a tolag chumann a chúvachan agus leis nach da vrean eit rí réaltas na halapa gaitis chúvach chumann eitja a haun an chógal. Ach, caí, chúj an scéalach mis an caíne mím a chunich mi an seach an seo. And nevertheless, the story reminded me of a meme I saw circulated this week of an exchange on Reddit. Now, please apply your senses of humour as I read this out, because it's certainly not serious. Anyway, the question was asked on r/Scotland, which said, "Hi, an Irish person here. I hope I don't come off as uneducated as a fool, but I was just wondering what you think Ireland and Scotland's relationship would be like if Scotland was to go independent." It seems an honest question, but it got a comedy answer, which is as follows. "I imagine after a short period of military build-up, we will declare war and mount an invasion in order to establish ourselves as the true dominant Gaelic power. As soon as the saltire is hoisted over Dublin Castle, we will mandate that all of your feathers be turned to point the right way, and that all your oars must be replaced with machs, and that all Seans must be forced to change their name to Éin." Fadders are the accents which point different ways in Ireland and Scotland according to the most recent spelling conventions, for those of you who didn't get that bit of it. Anyway, the answer finishes with Caed Mila Falcha Galapa Ajes Acharich, which translates as 100,000 welcomes to South Scotland, friend. Well, I measure er dol gatahas and galagering for Hion Garich, Gahari, Bian Cori, San Lolian as Ashgerim, Biakal Derning Arim Galagering, a Scrivig, Ach, a Kian Coralion, Hai Forest Gallur, Hegshin, I guess a Brian. I've been going along to Irish-speaking events recently, including informal conversation group at my local library. I'm always afraid to try writing in Irish, since the spelling is slightly different and I'm never exactly sure how. But after several days of getting used to it, I now find it fairly easy to understand and even speak. A recent meeting in Uist, following up on the recent Gaelic crisis in the vernacular community study, also thinks this is the way forward, when they said that informal situations are the best thing to encourage Gaelic conversation. Fa chania chian an yuist eich a chiadan a fa coia tri pesha chachorst eir a chanan sy'n sgir an solus an roed a chai olsiach eich fi chiongarach agus chola eit gyrae sewiachag nia aramol asiar sun sun cora gavros na chig sa galig. Chafwr yn ieganthus. Ach, sio o'r yn ela, I guess, at y fi ys tog o'm las dy sosial dy hau cael at y gyfelu a torst y choelio asiar rhain gys galig chymol. Chalna blu, es tog y ffawl. Here's one more song, and it seems to be giving us good advice for keeping Gaelic, as long as we maintain a social distance, of course. It's a chan of blue, a stag of faun. Oh, draw close and lift a tune. Is Cathy Ann McPhee singing A Chan of Blue, It's Tug of Fawn, O Draw Close and Lift a Tune. And that's all we have time for on today's programme. So, ha'akam nish ridash and evo manish for no radio alpadach, Australia Jess, Echo GBI N92.N FM. That's all we have time for today. Now, I've already said that on Scottish Radio Hour at 5UBI 103.1 FM. So it's goodbye from me, Rachel Hay. Cheery and drasta agasuri lev. He shin shiv and ah yachking. Ach ha follow me. Stati son and o radio erinach ekle uish. Scottish Radio Hour will be back at the same time next week. And of course, don't forget Celtic Radio Hour at 5 PM on Saturday. In fact, why go anywhere now? Stick around and listen to our friends at Irish Radio Hour coming up shortly at 1:30. Until then, have some dance music.